All right, what's going on, you guys? Nick here with Nick Strength and Power. So in this video, I want to talk about Flex Wheeler. Specifically, I want to look at his physique over the years and how it changed throughout his bodybuilding career from the beginning all the way until his comeback to the classic physique division. So Flex Wheeler is without a doubt one of the best bodybuilders in the history of the sport, one of the best to ever do it. At the time, he was the all-time Arnold Classic champion. Most titles won. At the time, he had won four, 1993, 1997, 1998, and 2000. That record was later broken by Dexter Jackson. Now, if you go to Flex Wheeler's first Olympia showing ever, the 1993 Mr. Olympia, his Olympia debut, he took second at the very first Olympia he ever competed at. Let's just pause for a second and appreciate how impressive that is. Second to Dorian Yates at his first Olympia ever. I believe it was his third pro show. He won his pro debut at the 1993 Ironman. He won the Arnold Classic in 1993, his first Arnold Classic ever, then went straight to the Olympia and got runner-up. And what a physique Flex Wheeler presented in 1992. It was a beautiful physique. It's what most people would aspire for their physiques to look like. It was aesthetic. It wasn't too big, but he had the size. Enough size to go against a guy like Dorian Yates. Dorian Yates, the man that a lot of people consider to be the person that ushered in the era of the mass monster. And Flex Wheeler, at his first Olympia ever, was able to go toe-to-toe with Dorian Yates and take second. His conditioning was incredible. His shape was incredible. His structure, incredible. His aesthetics, incredible. His lines, proportion, and symmetry. He was known as the Sultan of Symmetry. Incredible. 1993, Flex Wheeler, in my opinion, one of the best bodybuilders that the sport has ever seen. Now, Flex would go on to have a legendary bodybuilding career throughout the 90s. His placings would fluctuate. He would continue to win a bunch of pro shows, top placings at the Arnold, top placings at the Olympia. His Olympia placings would fluctuate a little bit for the most part. He was usually well in that conversation for the top three or four guys, many times top two. Now, they would fluctuate in the early 2000s, and they would begin to drop. 2002 specifically, where he dropped down to 7th place at the Olympia. So, this is what I wanted to compare in this video. Is if you look at early 1990s Flex Wheeler, you had a very different physique than what you saw from the early 2000s version of Flex Wheeler. Now, some might attribute that to the fact that, you know, bodybuilders were getting bigger and bigger as we got more and more into the 2000s and into this modern era of bodybuilding. The standards were changing, so the bodybuilders of that time were adjusting to meet the size criteria. Now, others say it was sight enhancement oil, like synthol, that led to the change in Flex Wheeler's physique. And I tend to agree with that. If you look at later photos of Flex Wheeler later on in his career, you see a really different physique, specifically throughout the arms and the shoulders is where you see the majority of that transformation. And I think you could make the argument that it is sight enhancement. Now, we don't know that for sure, but that would be the most likely cause of the dramatic change in the size and shape of his arms. See, we're not just talking about a size difference here. The shape of the arms changed. And when that happens, you're typically looking at some kind of sight enhancement, which honestly, there's really not a whole lot wrong with that if you do it the right way, because it's very common in bodybuilding. It's a lot more common in pro bodybuilding than a lot of people would like to admit. And that's not even meant to be a negative thing towards Flex. It's just worth noting that there was a massive shift in his physique between the early 90s and then the late 90s, latter half of his career, closer to the early 2000s. I mean, I can show you guys some side-by-side pictures here. I'll put up a side-by-side from 1993, early 90s versus late 90s, you can definitely see what I'm talking about. The shape of his arms and his shoulders, they changed. They definitely changed. But make no mistake about it, even with that noticeable change, Flex Wheeler was still a godlike physique, an incredible bodybuilder. And in my opinion, if you talk about uncrowned Mr. Olympias, look at the early 90s Flex Wheeler physique. That is an uncrowned Mr. Olympia. It, like I said before, it's one of the closest things that you could call perfection in bodybuilding. His proportions, his shape, his flow, his lines, his conditioning, his aesthetics. He nailed everything and never won an Olympia title. I think Flex is the best bodybuilder to never win an Olympia title, to be honest with you guys. Now, specifically, let's look at Flex's last competitive year in the early 2000s, 2003. Now, 2003, you start to see some serious warping happening in Flex Wheeler's arms. Now, whatever the cause of that is, I'll let you guys speculate in the comment section below. What do you guys think? Do you think it was sight enhancement oil? Do you think it was age? Do you think it was just him getting bigger? But if you look at photos from 2003, this 2003 Ironman Pro, his arms are seriously starting to look a lot rounder, a lot puffier, a lot fuller, and they're losing definition. That's one of the signs of sight enhancement oil, is gaining roundness and fullness but losing definition. And no, these photos are not photoshopped here. These are real photos of Flex Wheeler and his arms. And after that 2003 showing, you wouldn't see Flex Wheeler on a pro bodybuilding stage again until almost 15 years later at the 2017 Mr. Olympia, surprisingly, competing in the brand new Classic Physique category. Now, Flex Wheeler's comeback then and still is considered to be a controversial one considering all the health issues that Flex went through and is still going through. A lot of people questioned his decision to come back. Was it worth it to risk his health coming back? Now, Flex Wheeler ended up placing 15th out of 16 at the 2017 Mr. Olympia in the Classic Physique category. And arguably, it wasn't worth it from a placing standpoint, but he did prove a point. He proved the point that he could make that comeback and he could look impressive. I honestly think that for Flex Wheeler's age and all the things that Flex has been through, all the health conditions and all the other situations that he's gone through and he still is going through, that comeback was still incredibly impressive. He did have a classic look to his physique. His conditioning was great. His arms were huge. Those trademark Flex Wheeler arms were still there. So currently, Flex Wheeler is 54 years old, 3 years removed now from that comeback at the 2017 Mr. Olympia. He suffered a partial leg amputation, but he's still killing it in the gym, and he's still inspiring and motivating millions of people worldwide with his physique and his ability to overcome. And I just think that Flex Wheeler had one of the more interesting transformations over the course of his career. His physique, it just looks so different from the beginning to the end to the comeback. And I think it's one of the more impressive and interesting bodybuilding stories throughout bodybuilding history. That crazy, aesthetic, smaller, ripped condition physique that he brought in the early 90s, in contrast to the early 2000s, he was borderline a mass monster. Then 2017, he tries out Classic Physique. But in my opinion, Flex is still, to this day, an uncrowned Mr. Olympia champion and one of the best to ever do it. So let me know what you guys think in the comment section below. Please give this video a thumbs up if you did, in fact, enjoy it. Please subscribe to this channel if you have not subscribed yet already. And as always, Nick Strength and Power, signing out.